or mobile.
Take Fox Sports 1350 with you using iHeartRadio. It's the IE's home for sports.
KPWK AM 1350, Riverside, San Bernardino. An iHeartRadio station.
This is Robert Littell from BlackSportsOnline.com, and I'm out here with Fox 1350.
We are Fox Sports.
Yes, we are back in the great city of Riverside at the iHeartRadio station. It's IE Sportsnet, protected by the Riverside Sheriff's Association, live on Fox Sports AM 1350. I am your host, Eternal. When it comes to Inland Empire Sports, you know the conversation starts and stops here. Holla. Woo. We have a show today. Coach B left me stranded today, ladies and gentlemen. And so Eternal is here in the studio by himself, but I'm ready. I am equipped and ready for the job. We have a great show lined up today. We have Temecula Valley in the house. And let me tell you something. When I tell you it's going down, it is going down. We also have a very special guest, one of the star players from Centennial High School basketball will be live on the air. We're really excited about that. And then today we'll be live and direct at the Staples Center for the LA Clippers. And I know everybody's right now preparing for the Kobe Memorial that's going to be taking place. So a lot of great things that are happening here. And it's going to be a very interesting weekend. Obviously, going to be a lot of emotion going involved with the Kobe Bryant Memorial. So we want to make sure that we obviously send our thoughts and prayers out to everybody that was affected by that horrible incident. But again, it's going to be, we have a really, really great show lined up today. Excuse me. Coach B is on location. He'll be calling in just a little bit. And we have Miss Stacy Ann Holgate right here live in the studio as well today. So it's going to be a really, really great show. Right now, what's going on in the Inland Empire is basketball. A lot of huge basketball news. We're going to get to that in just a quick second. But I want you guys to make sure you stay tuned. We're going to go to a quick commercial break. We're going to come back. And then when we come back, we'll be talking about the CIF basketball, CIF Southern Section basketball. A lot of great things happen on the boys and girls front, and the world's to be discussed in our All-Star Games. We have All-Star Games aplenty coming up. April is the date. April is the month that you want to make sure that you are checking your calendars. April 5th, Sunday, April 5th, we'll be having the sixth annual Inland Valley Classic All-Star Game, San Bernardino, Pomona Valley All-Star Basketball Game, guys and gals. And then on the 19th, we'll be hosting the Riverside Sheriff's Association All-Star Basketball Game. That is the Riverside County All-Star Basketball Game. Will be taking place at Hillcrest. And then the granddaddy on April 26th will be Riverside versus San Bernardino. That is right, folks. Riverside versus San Bernardino in the 215 Classic. Really excited about this. It'll be Riverside taking on San Bernardino at the high school level, class of 2020. And that'll be taking place on Sunday, April 26th. You guys want to make sure you're marking your calendars. A lot of stuff happening in April. Really excited about it. And then in March, we'll be hosting the Inland Valley Hall of Fame Honors. We'll be honoring 10 outstanding student athletes. And these are football players within the San Bernardino County area who are performing great on the field and have a 3.8 or better in terms of grade point average, and who are also stewards of the community, doing community service out there and making sure that they're looking out for the community. So we really want to make sure we honor those kids doing a great job. We're really excited about it. Again, it's IE Sportsnet right here. You got Eternal on Fox Sports AM 1350. We're going to go to break, and when we come back, we'll have some special guests, and we'll be talking a little bit more about the CIF Southern Section Inland Empire basketball teams. Again, there's playoffs going on right now. So we'll be right back after this. So you're listening to IE Sportsnet, protected by the Riverside Sheriff's Association. When it comes to Inland Empire sports, you know the conversation starts and stops here, live on Fox Sports, AM 1350. We're right back after this.
You're listening to iesportsnet.com, the Inland Empire Sports Authority.
Score Sports has been a loyal partner in the sports industry for over 40 years. Founded in 1975, Score Sports has always been a family-owned and operated business located in the heart of Southern California. They offer a full line of youth and adult soccer uniforms, accessories and field equipment, youth and adult basketball uniforms and accessories and equipment. Score Sports can outfit your coaches and league referees as well, and much more. Their dedication and attention to detail has transformed Score Sports into one of the leading sport uniform manufacturers in the United States. Visit their spacious warehouse at 726 East Anaheim Street in Wilmington, or call them today at 800-626-7774. That's 800-626-7774. Or visit them on the web at scoresports.com. That's scoresports.com, at facebook.com/scoresports. Or on Twitter and Instagram with the handle Score Sports. That's ScoreSports.
Kinematics Physical Therapy and Sports Performance looks forward to partnering with you in the restoration of your wellness and expediting you back to your active life. We'd love to see you at our spacious clinic, conveniently located in Norco at 1801 3rd Street, Suite 101. Call us at 951-777-2178. That's 951-777-2178. Or visit our website at kptsport.com. Our clinic is an outpatient orthopedic clinic designed to treat general pain, post-operative conditions, and athletic rehabilitation using research standards of care. When you step through our doors, your pain becomes ours, and we will work diligently to help manage whatever life has thrown at you. We provide educational and screening services to the community free of charge. Services provided include health screenings, monthly health courses, sports venue coverage, and fundraising. We'd love to meet you at our spacious clinic, conveniently located in Norco at 1801 3rd Street, Suite 101. Call us at 951-777-2178. That's 951-777-2178. Or visit our website at kptsport.com. All are welcome who aren't afraid to recover their potential.
You know, one thing that I love is my daughter and I just had Daddy and Daughter Day, and we went to Stonefire Grill. And I'll tell you right now, I love the tri-tip, and you were saying that you loved what?
I'll take the potatoes.
Absolutely. I mean, those are the absolute best. You know what that's got me thinking about?
I don't.
It's got me thinking about lunch.
Oh, wow.
Thinking about what to eat for dinner or lunch, you can't go wrong with a freshly prepared, simply delicious meal from Stonefire Grill. Bring home our fresh-from-scratch salads, pizza, pasta, signature tri-tip, oh my God, chicken, and more.
Visit your neighborhood Stonefire Grill in Rancho Cucamonga in the Terra Vista Town Center on the corner of Haven Avenue and Foothill Boulevard, or skip the line and order ahead. Go to StonefireGrill.com for easy pickup and delivery options.
I tell you this, when we did the Inland Valley Sports Hall of Fame for 2 years in a row, they fed all of our people. And you know where me and my daughter went this past weekend?
Where'd you go?
Stonefire Grill.
Box combo, please.
At Raising Cane's, we're all about quality. We mix cane sauce in our restaurants every day, and our chicken is hand-battered and cooked to order. Our Texas toast is grilled with just the right amount of butter and garlic, and our lemonade is always freshly squeezed.
Love the window.
And why do we do all this? Because it makes a difference. Raising Cane's Chicken Fingers, one love.
Since 1952, ThinkWise Credit Union has served education professionals and families in Riverside, San Bernardino, and Orange counties. ThinkWise gives back to the community with financial education and support to local schools and organizations. Join us today to experience a safe and comfortable alternative to banking that gives back. ThinkWise Credit Union. You'll feel good about what we can accomplish together. Visit our website at thinkwisecu.org. Member NCUA, Equal Housing Lender, qualified members only.
What's up, world? This is your favorite comic, Tony Rock. And you're checking out Fox Sports.
We are Fox
Sports. Yes, we're back in the great city of Riverside at the iHeartRadio studios. As IE Sportsnet, protected by the Riverside Sheriff's Association, we are live on Fox Sports AM 1350. Again, it is your host, Eternal, right here live. My man, Coach B, is on location. Greg Holler's in the studio with me, man, so I appreciate Greg Holler being here. Give me a second here. So, yes, everybody, we want to make sure that we get a chance. Like I said, this weekend is going to be a bit of a somber weekend because, again, it will be the recognizing of the Kobe Bryant Memorial. Coach B and I will be live on location today for the L.A. Clippers basketball game, and we're really excited about that. Coach B and I, as you know, Coach B is the voice for the Agua Caliente Clippers, And anytime you guys want to check out the Agua Caliente Clippers, you can do that by visiting the Toyota Center. But today, the Clippers will be taking on the Sacramento Kings. And it'll be Kawhi Leonard coming off his MVP performance for the All-Star game. And that was something that everybody was really, really excited about. Kawhi Leonard, obviously from the Riverside County area. I got to make sure I put that out there. Riverside County area, Moreno Valley, you know, because everybody, you know, gets on me about that. I say Riverside, but, you know, because, again, King High School, Martin Luther King Jr. High School. And we want to make sure we recognize that again. So Coach B and I, make sure you check us out. Follow us. You can follow the story on IE Sportsnet. That's everywhere. Twitter, Instagram, and the Book of Faces, IE Sportsnet. And you will see us again. We'll be live at the Staples Center today, 12:30. And that will be for the LA Clippers when they take on the Sacramento Kings. Kawhi Leonard representing, coming off the big, big MVP performance. Last night, however, a big game last night was with the was with Etiwanda, and Etiwanda played last night a huge game against Sierra Canyon. And Sierra Canyon, you know, you have the Zaire Williams, BJ Boston, and Amari Bailey were the difference. And again, the trio, all three of those guys from Sierra Canyon had 23 points in the victory. And huge victory against Etiwanda. And again, it was 54-44. But today we're going to have a special guest. Really excited about it. We're going to have a player from Corona Centennial. He will be calling in here in just a quick second. Do we have a caller? Okay, I thought we had a caller. Okay, I'm going to make sure we're doing our thing. Because, again, I'm here in the studio by myself today, but I appreciate it. Also, we have the young ladies from Temecula Valley in the house. Really, really excited about that. And these are the young ladies on the water polo team for Temecula Valley. We're really excited about that. Now, we've had Temecula Valley on before. This will be the first time we've ever had the aquatics team on here. Our guy Bert Esposito has been on many a times and is actually a stable here on Fox Sports Radio, AM 1350 Riverside, San Bernardino. But again, we're going to have the trailblazing, the ladies from Temecula Valley water polo. Again, they are in here. Look, the girls water polo team, they are in here deep. When I tell you, I think it's 18 young ladies here. I'll be posting a picture in just a quick second, but we're really, really excited about that. They have been promoting the heck out of this thing, and we're really excited to have these young ladies in here. They're going to talk about their great season, and they also have a young lady who's been really doing some spectacular things and is a potential SoCal Athlete of the Week. That's Miss Abby Armstrong. So, again, want to make sure that you guys are ready for that. And as I mentioned to you, we will have Corona Centennial star basketball player calling in just a quick second. We're really excited about that. There she is, Miss Stacy. But again, it's going to be going down. Look, you guys can also be checking it. Make sure you guys look out for us. We're going to be, again, at the Staples Center. It is for the precursor. It's going to be the LA Clippers taking on the Sacramento Kings. And as you guys know, tomorrow will be the Kobe Bryant Memorial. And again, we will be on location for that as well. So we're going to get ready for our interview here in just a quick second. The show is going to be crazy. It's going to be a lot going on. You guys want to make sure that you stay tuned and stay locked in to Fox Sports AM 1350, myself, Eternal, and Coach B. Coach B will be calling in just a quick second. He is on location. And as I mentioned, he'll be calling in here a quick second. We have the Temecula Valley High School girls water polo team here in the studio. And like I said, it is like 18 young ladies. They are really, really excited to come on. So we can't wait for them. So we're going to go to break here. And we come back, we have a great interview coming on with the star basketball player for Corona Centennial. And he's coming off a huge game last night. And we'll talk to him in just a quick second. Again, it's IE Sportsnet, protected by the Riverside Sheriff's Association. Coach B and Eternal, when it comes to Inland Empire Sports, you know the conversation starts and stops here. Live on Fox Sports AM 1350. We're right back after this.
You're listening to IESportsNet.com, the Inland Empire Sports Authority.
Score Sports has been a loyal partner in the sports industry for over 40 years. Founded in 1975, Score Sports has always been a family-owned and operated business located in the heart of Southern California. They offer a full line of youth and adult soccer uniforms, accessories, and field equipment, youth and adult basketball uniforms and accessories and equipment. Score Sports can outfit your coaches and league referees as well, and much more. Their dedication and attention to detail has transformed Score Sports into one of the leading sport uniform manufacturers in the United States. Visit their spacious warehouse at 726 East Anaheim Street in Wilmington, or call them today at 800-626-7774. That's 800-626-7774. Or visit them on the web at scoresports.com. That's scoresports.com, at facebook.com/scoresports. Or on Twitter and Instagram with the handle Score Sports. That's ScoreSports.
Kinematics Physical Therapy and Sports Performance looks forward to partnering with you in the restoration of your wellness and expediting you back to your active life. We'd love to see you at our spacious clinic, conveniently located in Norco at 1801 3rd Street, Suite 101. Call us at 951-777-2178. That's 951-777-2178. Or visit our website at kptsport.com. Our clinic is an outpatient orthopedic clinic designed to treat general pain, postoperative conditions, and athletic rehabilitation using research standards of care. When you step through our doors, your pain becomes ours, and we will work diligently to help manage whatever life has thrown at you. We provide educational and screening services to the community free of charge. Services provided include health screenings, monthly health courses, sports venue coverage, and fundraising. We'd love to meet you at our spacious clinic, conveniently located in Norco at 1801 3rd Street, Suite 101. Call us at 951-777-2178. That's 951-777-2178. Or visit our website at kptsport.com. All are welcome whom aren't afraid to recover their potential.
You know, one thing that I love is my daughter and I just had Daddy and Daughter Day, and we went to Stonefire Grill. And I'll tell you right now, I love the tri-tip, and you were saying that you loved what?
I'll take the potatoes.
Absolutely. I mean, those are the absolute best. You know what that's got me thinking about?
I don't.
It's got me thinking about lunch.
Oh, wow.
Thinking about what to eat for dinner or lunch, you can't go wrong with a freshly prepared, simply delicious meal from Stonefire Grill. Bring home our fresh from scratch salads, pizza, pasta, signature tri-tip, oh my God, chicken, and more.
Visit your neighborhood Stonefire Grill in Rancho Cucamonga in the Terra Vista Town Center on the corner of Haven Avenue and Foothill Boulevard, or skip the line and order ahead. Go to StonefireGrill.com for easy pickup and delivery options.
I tell you this, when we did the Inland Valley Sports Hall of Fame for 2 years in a row, they fed all of our people. And you know where me and my daughter went this past weekend?
Where'd you go?
Stonefire Grill.
Box combo, please. At Raising Cane's, we're all about quality. We mix cane sauce in our restaurants every day. And our chicken is hand-battered and cooked to order. Our Texas toast is grilled with just the right amount of butter and garlic. And our lemonade is always freshly squeezed.
Love the window.
And why do we do all this? Because it makes a difference. Raising Cane's Chicken Fingers, one love.
Since 1952, ThinkWise Credit Union has served education professionals and families in Riverside, San Bernardino, and Orange counties. ThinkWise gives back to the community with financial education and support to local schools and organizations. Join us today to experience a safe and comfortable alternative to banking that gives back. ThinkWise Credit Union. You'll feel good about what we can accomplish together. Visit our website at thinkwisecu.org. Member NCUA, equal housing lender, qualified members only.
This is Rob and the Town from BlackSportsOnline.com, and I'm out here with Fox 1350.
We are Fox Sports.
Yes, we are back in the great city of Riverside at the iHeartRadio studios. It's IU Sports Net, protected by the Riverside Sheriff's Association. We are live on Fox Sports AM 1350. When it comes to Inland Empire Sports, you know the conversation starts and stops here, live on Fox Sports AM 1350. I am your host, Eternal. And again, I am right here live on Fox Sports AM 1350. It's going to be a really great game going on. But again, we have a special guest. We have Cameron Price from Etowanda High School. Caller, you're live on air. Can you hear me?
Yeah, how you doing?
Fantastic. Now, I wanted to make sure we got you on the air really appreciate you making the call. I know you had a game last night, so I wanted to make sure we got you in. But talk to us about the big game last night against Sierra Canyon.
You end up coming short. But you know, we played hard. We went on some runs. It was a close game all the way to the third quarter. And then they started going on a run, and once they got it to 10, and then we would knock it down a little bit, they would get back to 10. So it's like once they got to that 10 mark, then we can never knock it down completely. So, you know, we play hard. We just got to learn from what we the mistakes we made, the mental mistakes. It wasn't that, you know, we made, like, just flat out not playing hard and playing scared. It was just flat out mental mistakes. So once we learn from that, we'll be fine to where when we make a run in state and we get a chance to play them again or any other team that we play, we won't have those same mental mistakes.
Now, the great thing about that is what I'm really excited about it, what you guys have really accomplished over there, because you guys really put the Inland Empire on the map. And again, we're talking to Cameron Price right here for Etowanda High School. And again, I do apologize, I misspoke earlier. But you guys really did a great job this year of putting on the Inland Empire. I think a lot of people really kind of discounted what was going on here. How has the response been about your basketball team? Because again, you guys have went around and you guys have beat some real, real big talent, some huge teams. But how has it been? How's the response been for the basketball team here lately?
It's been good. I mean, you know, we're not surprised what we're doing. You know, everybody else is kind of a little shocked.
Right.
A little shocked at what we're doing. But some people might not be because they saw what we've been growing. I mean, all the guys that are on the team now have been here 3-4 years, and we all play freshmen together.
Oh, nice.
So everybody kind of watched the process. If you're like a real fan, I don't want to support her or whatever, you really watch the process and watch us get older and develop and stuff. So maybe somebody that don't really watch Etowanda like that and is just watching basketball might not know what we have, but everybody that's in the Etowanda family has known that, you know, we'll get to this point.
Right. And again, I mean, as you said, you know, you're coming off of that huge game against Sierra Canyon. What was the mindset for in terms of you as players going out there last night, taking on that basketball team? Because obviously it's a stacked basketball team. There's a lot of, you know, who's who names on there. But what was the mentality of the basketball team as players going into that game last night?
Yeah, well, when we played in December, we lost by 3. So we knew we could play with them. That wasn't the problem. It was just literally, it was just the mental mistakes that we had last night. We knew we couldn't have it that night. Like, we had to eliminate those or make very few of them.
Right.
But, you know, when we come into the game, we're like, we're fine. We just stick to our game plan, do what Etowanda does, play defense, make it our tempo, and we're fine. A ball game from then, you know, if we're late quarter, that's when your playmakers start making plays, game plan kind of windows down a little bit. So that's all we were doing, is try to stick to our game plan as much as possible.
Right.
And try to make them play towards our style of play rather than trying to play with them, because once you try playing their style of play, can't nobody do it like they do it. So
Exactly. And I know there was a delay in the game last night, and you guys had to kind of like work your magic around that delay in the game. But another thing what I wanted to talk to you about in particular, because I know, again, talking to Cameron Price, came off the game, had 13 points last night for Etowanda High School. But talk to me about your commitment. You recently made a commitment in terms of where you're going to be going to school for college. But talk to us about that commitment and how important that was for you and your family.
Yeah, I'm going to be going to Cal Poly San Luis Obispo. And it was important. You know, my relationship with the head coach is something that high school kids probably don't have that same situation going to their college. Coach John Smith, I've been knowing him since I was probably about 10, 11 years old. When he was at RCC, he used to open the gym up for me and his son to get shots up. All his best friends are all my previous travel ball coaches.
Right.
And so our relationship is like different. And it's very tight, and it's very family-oriented. he was my first, he was the coach that offered me at Fullerton. And then the first, and then once he got to San Luis Obispo, the minute he got the job, he called me and offered me. So, like, our friendship, but just the fact that we're family, and I'm family with his family, and he's family with our family, and it's a tight circle, just made it, like, an easy decision just to, from the standpoint of knowing if I go away from my family, a couple of hours away from my family, I'm still going to have a family there,
right,
family at the college, and I'm still going to have somebody there that I can trust and talk to regardless of if it's basketball, if it's life, stuff right. like that.
Right, right, right. And which is important because, again, as you mentioned, that's one of those things where you're obviously, or you're a young man, you're coming in, and it's important to have those relationships. But on a basketball level, I got a chance to talk to Coach John Smith off the air.
Mm-hmm.
He's really excited about you coming in. But as a basketball perspective, what do you think you're going to be adding to Cal Poly San Luis Obispo? In terms of as a player, what will you be bringing to the table?
I think I'll be bringing to the table a little bit of everything from my game standpoint, just all around. You know, the score, if I need a score, being able to facilitate when I need to facilitate, do a little, I can defend, I can rebound. I rebound really well at my size. And, you know, and then just from the mental standpoint, just the, like last night, I played in big games. Of course, we lost, but just the mentality to play in big games, situational stuff, you know, be able to play in, I played in regional semifinals, and every year I've been on varsity. And so, like, just to play in big games, I, you know the game, knowledge is high level, a high IQ.
Right.
You know, just a winner mentality is something I can bring over to Cal Poly next year, in the next couple of years.
Fantastic. And again, man, thank you so much for coming on the air. Best of luck to you guys, man. We'll be keeping tabs on you. Again, we have Cameron Price right here from Etowanda Basketball. He is making his made his commitment right here already. But again, he will be taking his talents to Cal Poly San Luis Obispo. Again, man, thank you so much. Have a great weekend, man. And thank you. I appreciate you calling in. Okay.
Thank you for having me.
There it is right there again. Cameron Price right there. Really appreciate that young man calling in today after a big game. And like I said, one of those situations is difficult for, a kid like that. Because I know in the third quarter, a scuffle broke out. And unfortunately, it affected Etowanda more so because they Sierra Canyon ended up going on a 17-5 run after the stoppage of play. So, you know, it was one of those situations where, you know, you just wish that you allowed the game to stay on the court. But again, Etowanda really has just really done a great job of putting on for the Inland Empire. And again, led by Cameron Price as well as Jalen Clark. So again, it's IE Sportsnet right here. We have coming up some special young ladies who are doing some amazing things. They have been patiently waiting. I really appreciate them. Temecula Valley Water Polo. Let me tell you something. These young ladies are doing some really, really great things. They will be here in the studio. So you guys want to make sure you stay tuned to that. Again, it's IE Sportsnet right here live on Fox Sports AM 1350, protected by the Riverside Sheriff's Association. When it comes to Inland Empire Sports, you know the conversation starts and stops here live on Fox Sports AM 1350. We're right back after this.
You're listening to iesportsnet.com, the Inland Empire Sports Authority.
Score Sports has been a loyal partner in the sports industry for over 40 years. Founded in 1975, Score Sports has always been a family-owned and operated business located in the heart of Southern California. They offer a full line of youth and adult soccer uniforms, accessories, and field equipment, youth and adult basketball uniforms and accessories and equipment. Score Sports can outfit your coaches and league referees as well, and much more. Their dedication and attention to detail has transformed Score Sports into one of the leading sport uniform manufacturers in the United States. Visit their spacious warehouse at 726 East Anaheim Street in Wilmington, or call them today at 800-626-7774. That's 800-626-7774. Or visit them on the web at scoresports.com. That's scoresports.com, at facebook.com/scoresports. or on Twitter and Instagram with the handle Score Sports. That's SCORESPORTS.
Kinematics Physical Therapy and Sports Performance looks forward to partnering with you in the restoration of your wellness and expediting you back to your active life. We'd love to see you at our spacious clinic, conveniently located in Norco at 1801 3rd Street, Suite 101. Call us at 951-777-2178. That's 951-777-2178. Or visit our website at kptsport.com. Our clinic is an outpatient orthopedic clinic designed to treat general pain, postoperative conditions, and athletic rehabilitation using research standards of care. When you step through our doors, your pain becomes ours, and we will work diligently to help manage whatever life has thrown at you. We provide educational and screening services to the community free of charge. Services provided include health screenings, monthly health courses, sports venue coverage, and fundraising. We'd love to meet you at our spacious clinic, conveniently located in Norco at 1801 3rd Street, Suite 101. Call us at 951-777-2178. That's 951-777-2178. Or visit our website at kptsport.com. All are welcome who aren't afraid to recover their potential.
You know, one thing that I love is my daughter and I just had Daddy and Daughter Day, and we went to Stonefire Grill. And I'll tell you right now, I love the tri-tip. And you were saying that you loved what?
I'll take the potatoes.
Absolutely. I mean, those are the absolute best. You know what that's got me thinking about?
I don't.
It's got me thinking about lunch.
Oh, wow.
Thinking about what to eat for dinner or lunch, you can't go wrong with a freshly prepared, simply delicious meal from Stonefire Grill. Bring home our fresh-from-scratch salads, pizza, pasta, signature tri-tip, oh my God, chicken, and more.
Visit your neighborhood Stonefire Grill in Rancho Cucamonga in the Terra Vista Town Center on the corner of Haven Avenue and Foothill Boulevard, or skip the line and order ahead. Go to StonefireGrill.com for easy pickup and delivery options.
I tell you this, when we did the Inland Valley Sports Hall of Fame for 2 years in a row, they fed all of our people. And you know where me and my daughter went this past weekend?
Where'd you go?
Stonefire Grill.
Box combo, please. At Raising Cane's, we're all about quality. We mix cane sauce in our restaurants every day. And our chicken is hand-battered and cooked to order. Our Texas toast is grilled with just the right amount of butter and garlic. And our lemonade is always freshly squeezed.
Love the window.
And why do we do all this? Because it makes a difference. Raising Cane's Chicken Fingers, one love.
Since 1952, ThinkWise Credit Union has served education professionals and families in Riverside, San Bernardino, and Orange counties. ThinkWise gives back to the community with financial education and support to local schools and organizations. Join us today to experience a safe and comfortable alternative to banking that gives back. ThinkWise Credit Union. You'll feel good about what we can accomplish together. Visit our website at thinkwisecu.org. Member NCUA, equal housing lender, qualified members only.
BlackSportsOnline.com, and I'm out here with Fox 1350.
We are Fox Sports.
Yes, we are back in the great city of Riverside at the iHeartRadio studios. It's IE Sportsnet Protected by the Riverside Sheriff's Association. We are live on Fox Sports AM 1350. I am your host, Eternal. Brother B, how you doing, sir?
No, you are listening to IE Sportsnet. Eternal tried to shut me out. You couldn't do it, man. So I had to call in and let my public know because they've been texting me. They've been calling me. I want them to know I'm okay. I just had some things come up. I wanted to apologize to Temecula Valley Women's Water Polo. I wanted to introduce myself and get to know them. They were texting me this morning. I just want to let them know I apologize. I had an emergency situation come up, but I will be back next week, Lord willing.
No doubt about it. Well, we're really excited about it. I know that you are doing the Agua Caliente Clippers game, but I know we recently did the UCR basketball game. Talk to us a little bit about that, man. I mean, that was a really great game. We saw them compete against Cal Poly San Luis Obispo. But talk to us about how you felt about that experience.
It's a good experience. Where, you know, as you know, we broadcast, like you said, the Agua Caliente Clippers, the official NBA G League of the Los Angeles Clippers, and now we're getting our foot into the UCR, and I know that's special to you because you're born and raised in Riverside.
Indeed.
So, you know, it's a great thing to be involved and bring some excitement. We saw some comments where people really love the broadcast, so we know we're doing something right. And at the end of the day, our mission has always been, we created IE Sportsnet, was to bring excitement to the Inland Empire. So we're excited to have the opportunity. We want to thank UCR for their faith and trust in us, and we're just trying to grow this thing every day.
Indeed. And again, we will be on location today at the Staples Center covering the L.A. Clippers. They're going to be taking on the Sacramento Kings. How you feeling about that game today, man?
I'm feeling good, man. So what I'm going to do is, when I get there, I'm going to go right up to Kawhi Leonard, and I'm going to tell Kawhi, can you tell Eternal that you're from Moreno Valley and not Riverside? So that way, we can hear directly from the man himself.
Oh, my goodness. You know what? And guess what he's going to say? He's going to say Riverside. No doubt about it. But again, man, thank you so much for calling in. Again, that's Coach B right there. We will be on location today at the Staples Center covering the L.A. Clippers taking on the Sacramento Kings. Coach B, man, thank you so much for calling in today.
Absolutely. You know, one thing, I heard you talking to the young man, and we can go, did my Etowah the Eagles win yesterday?
Woo! They did not. They fell. But let me tell you something. They competed. They competed. You know, there was a scuffle that broke out. It was one of those get your hand out of my pocket moments. They scuffle broke out, and they didn't get a chance to really – respond after that. But again, they fell to Sierra Canyon. But Etowah, Cameron Price said they're going to be taking them on again. So look out for the Eagles.
Okay, that sounds good, man. I appreciate it, man. I'll see you later on today, brother.
There it is right there. Coach B calling in on the Boost Mobile Celebrity Be Heard Hotline. However, we do have very, very special guests in the studio. Go ahead, pull that microphone up, Coach, right there, and introduce yourself to the Fox Sports Radio audience.
Hey, my name's Cameron Campbell. I'm the girls water polo coach at Temecula Valley High School.
Man, you guys, let me tell you something. You guys have really, my phone has been jumping off the hook right now because of all the response you guys have gotten. But talk to us about your season. You got some special young ladies that you're coaching right now. But just kind of give our audience some background about you and how you got involved in coaching.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I've been playing water polo for a long time, 5 years before I started coaching. And right after I stopped playing in high school, I started coaching at our local club team. And from there, I worked my way into this head coaching spot at Temecula Valley.
You said, I worked my way into that. That's a good thing. Now, I mean, the environment there is a culture. We're very familiar with Coach Esposito as he made his transition over there with football. But again, with your team this year in particular, you guys have done some great things. Talk about this team that you have and what's been special about these young ladies this particular year.
Yeah, absolutely. These girls last year was our growth year.
Right.
And they put so much work into the off season, and we came back this season ready to hit it hard. And, they've just been working so, so hard. And that's why we saw so much success this year, is all that dedication, that effort that they put in. Wherever they're at.
Now, because a lot of times with coaches, they it's always difficult because you're not just coaching with the players, you have the parents.
Yeah.
And that's always a PR move right there. But obviously you have a, you have a support system. How has it been right there working with the players as well as the parents as well?
It's been awesome. We have a great parent support group in our program that takes care of everything that we need. And the girls, they just go above and beyond. We got some amazing stuff this year for our pool, and a lot of awesome opportunities for the girls.
Well, fantastic. What we're going to do is, without further ado, I know you're like, hey, you know, it's cool you talk about me, but we want to make sure we bring the players in here. So we'll start off with Abby. Am I saying her name right? I want to make sure I'm saying his name correct right here.
Nipsher.
Ah, yes. Abby Nipsher. Yeah. See, we... So let's bring Abby in. Matter of fact, we'll have all the girls come out here so that way they can just come on in. But Abby, let's go ahead and have you come on in here. Pull that microphone up. You can just stand up because we're gonna have everybody coming in just a quick second here. But please introduce yourself to the Fox Sports Radio audience.
Hello, I am Abby Nipsher. I play for TVHS Water Polo.
Fantastic, and I like the way you said that. TVHS.
Yep.
tell me about what position you play. And how long have you been playing water polo?
So I play set, and I have been playing water polo since my sophomore year.
Okay.
Because I got hurt, and water was the thing I could do, and so that's how I got into it.
Now, what a lot of people may have a misconception about what happens with water polo. Kind of give our audience, if they don't know what happens in water polo, kind of give us a snapshot of how the sport of water polo.
Okay, so to translate it for people that don't really know what water polo is, so it's kind of like soccer but set up in the water.
Okay.
So you have your goalie, and then you have six people in the water, and there's perimeter, and then the people, you have obviously offense and defense, and then the rules are a little bit weird.
Right.
But by setup, like the two, the five, and the seven, and so just.
And how
like
many?
That.
And how many are your teammates in the water at one time?
Seven of us.
Seven of you guys.
Yeah.
Now, how does it feel when it's out there? Because I know you guys get loud. I've seen some of the video. You guys are like screaming and shouting out there. How is it? I mean, how is it like when you know you guys have that support of your teammates out there and you guys are in the water competing?
When you have that support of your team, it feels like nothing else. Having that support, it's just a family.
Fantastic. Well, thank you so much. I appreciate it. We're going to have Kansas come up next.
All right.
Look at that. It's almost like who's coming up next? It's like a roll of young ladies. And you ought to see, this is a great scene right here. Go ahead and introduce yourself to the Fox Sports Radio audience, please.
Hi, I'm Kansas Polk, and I'm from Temecula Valley High School.
Now, an interesting fact, we always write this on here, and you said you have the smallest feet on the team. How were you able to find that out?
So I wear like Vans, and they're size 4.5, and then we all like compare like our feet sizes, and I'm the smallest feet.
There it is right
the
there.
Smallest feet.
Now, what's been special about this team for you? Because, again, you're playing it. You're surrounded with these young ladies. I'm sure you guys go to school together. And, I mean, you guys are hanging out with each other all the time. But what is special about this team for you?
We're all so, like, welcoming. And it's, like, we're all, like, a family. And we all help each other with, like, our challenges and our accomplishments. And if we have any questions with, like, anything, we all, like, help each other and answer those questions.
Well, fantastic. Thank you so much. And best of luck to you guys, okay?
Thank you.
We have Allie now. She's like, oh, wait a minute. Oh. There it is right there. It looks like there's a couple of Allies on there. come on up. There you go. So go ahead and introduce yourself. Name and a full name and what position you play.
I am Allie Pritchett. I'm a senior at Temecula Valley High School, and I play field.
Okay. Now, you said you're a twin.
Yes.
Is your twin here?
No, she's not.
What's your twin's name?
My sister is Adelaide Pritchett.
Okay. Now, how do your teammates know? Can you go in there and be like, can she like do a stunt double for you, or will your teammates know?
They would know. Actually, I think it depends on the girl. We both played my sophomore year in high school, and then we both took a break junior year, and then I came back for senior year, and she didn't come back. So I feel like that alone time kind of might have confused some people.
Well, there it is right there. Now, again, I want to make sure that I tell you on air, we know who you are now. So everybody on Fox Sports Radio AM 1350 knows about you. Tell me something special about your team.
I just think that we have a very welcoming environment. Coming back from having an off season, I was really stressed about having people think that I was not going to fit in with my skill level, because I knew like I was not up to par with everybody else. So I would have to be putting in a lot of extra work. And so that was something that was always in the back of my mind, being like, oh, I don't want to mess this up for everybody else.
Right.
And that was nothing. Like when we actually got into season and got in the water, we were so welcoming and inviting. And it was like, no, it was like I had never taken a season off. They were all so like excited to have me back, and it was awesome.
Well, fantastic. Well, best of luck to you. Keep up the good work, okay?
Thank you so much.
There it is right there. We have Josie Smith coming up. Now, I want to make sure you get a chance to introduce full name and what position you play.
Hi, I'm Josie Smith, and I play field at Temecula Valley High School.
Now, you said you like to draw in your spare time.
I do.
Now, what are the things that you like? Are you're drawing? I mean, what do you like to draw in particular?
I just like to draw like cartoons and stuff like that. Like a lot, I watch a lot of cartoons.
What's your favorite cartoon? Okay, now there we go. Now, what's your favorite cartoon? Because I have some. I'm an old guy. Like you know, Flintstones are my thing. What do you like?
Oh, I don't know. There's a lot. I guess I like the show called Steven Universe. It's on Cartoon Network.
You know what? You got me on that one. You tell me.
Yeah.
Now tell me something special about your team.
I just think that we're really close, and I like the fact that we're really close. And I like the fact that we have good energy and we like to support each other. And whenever you're feeling down and you're just having a bad day, they're there to lift you up or lift me up. Especially when we're about to play a game and you're like really nervous. So I feel that that these girls will help you stay positive and keep a good energy on the team.
Well, fantastic, Ms. Smith. I really appreciate your time today, okay?
Thank you.
Keep up the good work. We have coming up, we have Ms. Dominguez. Am I saying that right? All right, fantastic. Come on up. Let's go ahead and introduce yourself, full name, and what position you play.
Hi, I'm Maddie Dominguez, and I'm a senior at Temecula Valley High School, and I play 2-meter defense.
2-meter defense. Okay, now tell me... tell me what that position means, because again, you know, I'm new to water polo, go ahead, educate our audience about what that position does.
So it's one of the most aggressive positions in the pool. It's right in front of the goalie, and you are full contact, chest to chest with a girl. So it is rough and it's grabby and I love it.
Now, you said on here you have the best hair on the team.
I do. They have told me that.
Okay, so that's what they've told
yes,
you.
Yes, that was not self-elected.
There it is, no doubt about it. Now, I'll ask you the same question. What is special about your team this year?
This year, we're a family. Something happened like at one of our tournaments this year, and we just like we came together. We all like flipped our switches, and we were aggressive, and we were there for each other. We were supportive.
Well, fantastic. Again, you guys seem like you guys have a great team. Thank you so much for being here today, okay?
Thank you.
And then we have coming up next, we have Alina. And go ahead and come on up. She has the denim jacket on today. Let's go ahead and introduce a full name and what position you play.
Hi, I'm Elena Kendall, and I'm a utility player.
Utility player. Now, again, for the old guy that doesn't know anything about water polo, educate our audience about what that position does.
So basically, I can be moved around anywhere in the pool except for a set player or a set D player.
Okay. And what's special about your team for you this year?
I think pretty much like what everybody said, we have come together as a family this year more than ever. And I think that really strengthened our team and our team morality.
Fantastic. Well, you know what? Congratulations. Thank you so much for being here today, okay?
Thank you.
All right, there it is right there. We're moving right along. We have there is another Abby on this team. We have like Abby 1, Abby 2, Abby 3. But go ahead and we have your introduce yourself, full name, what position you play.
I'm Abby Armstrong. I play for TVHS Water Polo and I'm the goalie.
Okay. Oh, you're goalie.
Yeah.
We finally got the goalie here. Now, one of the things I do know about water polo is that you are in there treading water for quite some time.
Yeah.
Tell me about like what goes into that. In terms of like the workout, how you have to work out to prepare for that.
Yeah, like when you first start water polo, like treading water, it takes like a week or two, depending on the person, like to tread water, and you have to like try to kind of counterclockwise, like moving your legs together at the same time.
Right.
But then once you like start doing it, it's like comes part of your brain.
Right.
And then you like don't forget it, and so when you get in the pool, you just do it automatically.
And I'll ask you the same question: what's special about your team this year?
I think like we can be ourselves around each other and we're just like crazy together and it's just like able to have like a fun time and play the game that we love.
Well, I appreciate you coming on today. Mm-hmm. Thank you so much. Keep up the good work, okay?
Thanks.
There it is right there. Again, we have Temecula Valley High School water polo right here in the studio today. And again, these young ladies are ready to go. We have Grace. Grace, I don't know. Come on up, Grace. Grace may have... if I do say so myself, may have the best penmanship I've seen so far. it almost looks like you typed this. My goodness, this is legit right here. You said you love dance. Well, let me have you introduce yourself first and what position you play. Excuse me.
I'm Grace Hawkins, and I'm a senior at TV, and I'm a utility player.
You're a utility player as well. Now, you like dancing. What is the dance that the Temecula Valley girls are doing right now?
Well, it's like all styles. We kind of focus on hip-hop.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, okay, let me ask you this. This is a major question. What song is it that gets you guys fired up right before a big match?
Probably the song Get Silly.
Look, everybody's like, yeah, that's the one right there.
That's now, usually the hype song.
There it is right there. Now, I'd ask you the same question. What's been special about your team this year?
Well, coming from last year and going through kind of a hard route to get to where we are at the beginning of the season, especially also losing a couple games, I feel like in the middle of the season, we finally all came together and we started hanging out and bonding and something clicked with all of us. We learned each other's strengths, and I think that's something really special that we found.
Well, again, congratulations. You guys are doing a great job. Keep up the good work, okay?
Thank you so much.
Fantastic. We have Miss Helper.
Hepler.
Oh, she's like, get it right. Go ahead and introduce yourself. Full name, what position you play?
Hi, I'm Jaden Hepler. I'm a junior at Temecula Valley, and I am a utility player.
Okay, and I'll ask you the same question, Ms. Hepler. What is special about this team this year for you?
I think after last year, it was really rough to come back into this team, and, like, we all realized, okay, like, the reason we're going to be good this year is if we become a team, and we all really have become a team and just really close and, like, good friends that we weren't last year. And so I think that, like, just became, like, the reason that we were as good as we did this year.
And you said you have maintained a 4.0. Is that, she said, no, that's not me. I'm sorry about that. Ah, pastry.
Yes.
You cook.
I do.
Okay, now what is the thing you like to cook? She's like, no, that's not me. I do apologize. Sorry about that.
I like to bake a lot. So I bake, like, cookies and stuff like that all the time. But, like, that's what I want to get to eventually after my water polo career would end.
Well, again, thank you so much for being here today. Keep up the good work, okay?
Thank you.
Appreciate it. We have Kyle coming up. Kylie. I said Kyle. They're like, yeah. Oh, God, get it together. So, full name, what position you play?
Okay, hi, I'm Kylie Ballou, and I am a junior at TV, and I'm an attacker.
I'm sorry, you're a what now?
Attacker.
Attacker. Is that what you said? Wow. Okay. So tell me what an attacker does. I mean, outside of the obvious.
So we can counterattack, like, when you're up on the other team. And then I drive in to set and try and post up and get the ball. Yeah.
Fantastic. Now, how has it been? And you are the young lady with the 4.0. So yeah. How has it been trying to maintain that while you're still playing sports?
It's kind of hard, but it's definitely taught me, like, how to time manage. And it's, yeah.
Well, again, thank you so much for being here today. We appreciate you. Keep up the good work, young lady, okay?
Thank you.
Fantastic. And then we have Allie. And I hope I'm saying that correctly.
Yeah.
All right. She's like, so full name of what position you play, please.
I'm Allie Huber, and I'm also a utilities player.
And you said you're the only lefty on the team.
Well, the goalie, Abby, is also a lefty, but it's not the same.
It's not the same?
Yeah. Because when you're in field, it's different, yeah.
It's different. Okay, now I'll ask you the same thing. What's been special about this team for you?
I think that it's just been, like, so great being able to have fun with our team. Like, I know the past, like, couple years on varsity, we've all had, like, struggles, like, connecting as teams, and I just think this year, like, we really, like, connected, and, like, we can all have fun with each other, and it's been great.
Well, again, thank you so much for being here today, okay?
Thank you.
There it is. We have Sam. Come on up, Sam. Sam's ready to go.
Hey, girl.
She's the firecracker of the bunch, I can see. So go ahead. Full name, what position you play?
I'm Sam League, and I am an attack player at TV.
Now, tell me about these silly noises that you can make.
Do you want me to make them?
Yes.
Oh, okay. let me prepare myself. Which one do you want me to do?
Everybody has their phones out right now.
Pterodactyl or Minecraft zombie?
You can do a pterodactyl?
Yeah. Okay, hold on. I don't want to do it too loud on the microphone.
No, like, handle it. Just, okay. just kind of take a step, just a little step back, okay, and then go for it. Well, you know what? You've just become famous right there. That's probably going to go viral right there. But I'll ask you the same thing. What's been special about your team for you?
Oh, I love all of them so much. We made it pretty far this season, so I'm just really proud of everyone on our team.
Well, again, thank you so much. I appreciate you.
Thank you.
We have Miss Carlton. Come on up. All right, there she She had her phone out ready to go.
Yes,
full name, what position you play?
I'm Cadence Carlton. I'm a junior at TVHS, and I'm a utility player also.
And I'll ask you, because we have to kind of keep it moving, I'll ask you, what's been special about your team for you?
I think after all these 3 years, this year has really hit home because we've all really come together, and I always feel like I have a home to come to when it's on the pool deck. And no matter what's going on in my life or outside, I'm always able to come there and know that I'm going to have fun and have a second family that I love, and we do the sport we love. So.
Well, we appreciate it. Keep up the good work, young lady, okay?
Thank you.
There it is right there. We have Temecula Valley Water Polo. We have, come on up. Name and what position you play.
I'm Rachel Dixon, and I play 2-meter defense.
Fantastic. Now, tell me what's special about your team for you.
This year especially, we've just gotten so much closer, like everybody else has been talking about. I feel like when we hang out, we just are so close and know each other so well. It's no stress, no drama this year compared to last year especially.
I like it. There it is. I like that. Go ahead and keep up the good work, young lady. Thank you for being here today. And we have coming up next, Go ahead. Full name and what position you play?
Oh, my name is Indiana Rivera. I'm a senior at Temecula Valley High School. I play water polo.
Okay, fantastic. And what's been special about your team for you?
Oh, special about my team? Well, this is my first year on varsity. The years before that, I've seen the varsity team struggle a bit. And what's really cool this year is that we can all come together and just be a team I've seen that, like, years before, and that's never really happened fully, but this year I think we have a great team dynamic.
Fantastic. Well, thank you so much for being here today. We'll just bring them on in, and whoever hasn't been interviewed yet, we'll have you come on in and name what position you play.
Hi, I'm Emma Wetlaufer, and I play attack.
Okay, and then what's been special about the team for you?
I feel like this year we really kind of came together and acted like a team. In years past, we've been a team, but we didn't have the whole dynamic, so this year we're actually playing like one.
I like that. I like to hear that. Temecula Valley Water Polo in the house. There it is. Thank you so much for being here today. Who's up next? Full name, what position you play?
My name's Kennedy Cross, and I'm a sophomore, and I also play attack.
Okay. And then what's been special about your team this year?
Well, last year I was on JV, and I feel like from moving up to varsity, I've had like a lot of support from all the girls, and it's been really fun to hang out with them outside of practice and in practice.
There it is right there. I appreciate that. Who's up next? Who hasn't been interviewed yet? We're all wrapped up. Fantastic. Coach, come on up. Come back up here real quick. Coach, again, wow, what a spirited group of young ladies you have right there, Coach.
Yeah, absolutely.
Now, what's up next for you guys?
Right now, we're in the off season. We're looking to start club water polo, and we're just looking forward to next year.
Well, again, Temecula Valley Water Polo, thank you guys for being here. Thank you guys for your patience. You guys have a great team, great school. And again, like I said, we know you guys from Coach Esposito. So again, keep up the good work, and we'll be in contact with you guys, okay?
Thank you. Thank you for having us.
There it is right there. Temecula Valley Water Polo right here live on Fox Sports AM 1350. I'm going to take a picture with you guys, so guys, hang on in the back for a quick second. Stacey Ann Holgate is coming up here next. Now, let me tell you something about this. We always talk about this often, and it does not work without the support from people that come on without our support. But Stacey Ann is here. Stacey Ann, Farmers Insurance. Bum, 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 bum. Everybody knows that. Introduce yourself to the Fox Sports Radio, the lady that needs no introduction.
Good morning. Good morning. My name is Stacey Ann Holgate with Farmers Insurance.
Now, Stacey, where can we talk about this all the time? We talk about the services you provide, but what are the services that you do? What do you provide, and where can they get in contact with you?
So I'm basically all over all social media platforms. I'm on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. You can easily identify me through S. Holgate Agency. Google is our best friend nowadays.
Yes, it is. Everybody says Google me.
Just Google me. I'm located right across the street from CBU, 3641 Adams Street.
Fantastic. Now, we talk about this all the time, and there's some of the services you provide, because you do auto insurance, I mean, home insurance, I mean, whatever. If insurance is associated with it, you do it. Well, but one of the more important things we always talk about is life insurance, because, again, I mean, there's been so much, you know, we're talking about Kobe Bryant, we're talking about some of those people that have been unfortunately lost their life in that horrible accident, and that stuff happens. It just happens to regular people all the time. And if you don't have that protection, talk to us about the importance of having that life insurance and how they can get in contact with you about that.
Definitely. So life insurance, it's honestly really, really cost affordable to most people. The older you wait to get it, the more expensive it's going to become. So talk to a professional now. Message me, DM me, hit me up. Again, that's S. Holgate Agency on Twitter or on Facebook or on Instagram. Let me sit down and talk with you about how affordable it really is to protect your family in the unfortunate event that something does happen to you or the primary breadwinner of your home. We want to make sure that all our families are going to be protected. Like, we live to protect them during our lives. Why not continue to do so after death?
And again, you have been just great hanging out with us. You've just been a great resource, just talking to us about the insurance and about the importance of it. And again, make sure you inform our audience again how they can get in contact with you. Stacey Ann Holgate, Farmers Insurance, how can they get in contact with you?
Again, I'm on all social media platforms, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, S. Holgate Agency, located right across the street from CBU, 3641 Adams Street. Phone number 951-977-9899.
Fantastic. And again, thank everybody so much for tuning in today. Stacey Ann Holgate was right here in the studio. She's so patient. I appreciate it so much. And Coach B was on location today. I had to do it myself today.
Woo. You did great, though.
Thank you so much. I appreciate that. You know, you had to huff it out. I thought it was like one player from Temecula Valley. It was a whole team. But thank you so much for Temecula Valley Water Polo, the Aquatics, for coming in today. Big shout out to our guy, Cameron Price, Cal Poly San Luis Obispo commit, Etowah High School. Again, we will be on location today at the LA Clippers for the Clippers against the Sacramento Kings. It's Fox Sports Radio, AM 1350. I am your host, Eternal, and we will see you again next week. Big up to my man, Greg Holland. Thank you, man. Tune in next week.
You're listening to iesportsnet.com, the Inland Empire Sports Authority.